Hello, Chris White here, Perry Croft Bees. Just for the sort of records, I'd just like people to sort of see what colonies are like when they become really aggressive. This colony has been upset to the point where smoke doesn't actually work on it anymore, which is very annoying because I've taken the super off and now I need to try and get it back together again without them going berserk. But sort of give you an idea of the roar that they make. The fact they run out on the top and they'll come after you en masse. Not vicious, but enough to make them go away. I'll just sort of give you an idea of what next is happening already. So I'm not excited to do here. Let them cool down a bit and then get them again with some more smoke. What I'll be doing here is re-queening this stock. The other colonies, although they have some of the traits of aggression, are actually quite quiet today. This was the last one, thankfully. So I will take some eggs from there and put it into this aggressive colony once I've removed the queen and let them go hopelessly clean this. It's going to be a task with this colony, I think. Anyway, these things are part of nature. I just need to learn how to handle the bees and not to do something when they really, really don't want you to do it. Otherwise, you're going to get stung to hell. Okay, thanks. And again, Chris White here, Perry Croft Bees, part two. I've given them a few minutes and then hit them with a bit of smoke on the top of the frames to drive them down into the lower box so they're less flighty. I've just learnt something new. If I puff it in from the main entrance, like I normally do as well, that drives them up onto the top where they can see me and they get a little annoyed. They are calming down a bit now, and so I've managed to remove all that burr comb that was on the top on the previous video. That said, I'm just going to let them calm again a bit, and then I'm going to drive them down frame, and then I'm going to put the super back on. It looks like they're very honey bound actually, which is my fault, and it looks like they may be either lost the queen or getting ready to swarm when they get like this. So I think the answer is I'll come back another day once I get the roof and the super back on. Okay. So again, Chris White here, Perry Croft Bees, part three. I give them some time to calm down. I smoke the top of the frames, push them down into the lower box, and I put the super back on. You know, they're, if handled correctly, they're not
a menace, but
if these were handled incorrectly, they would really, really work. It's about being gentle with them. Lots of smoke, and smoke obviously in the right areas. As you can see, they're fanning at the entrance to call their friends back into the main entrance, and they will settle. It isn't the best day today, it's overcast. I do find that these wild strains, if you want to call them wild strains, they are a bit more touchy in cloudy, wet weather. But that's, I can't afford not to open them. I only open them in the sunny time, so I've got to do something with these. But anyway, we're back in the situation under control. They aren't aggressive that much anymore at the entrance. Obviously, if I was walking closer, they would start to fan out. That behaviour at the entrance is, I think it's just calling everybody back in through the main entrance. It's not them coming out to sort of kill anything that happens to come nearby. Okay, that said, that just gives you an idea what moderately aggressive bees can get like.